Yeah, the question was, can I tell you any causes for the loss of aircraft? Because I said we lost 18. There were 12 SRs. There was one of them, was full of fuel, came off the tanker, and it got a little too slow. And the aircraft, because there's so much lifting body in the front of the airplane, when you start to get too slow, the center of lift runs back, and next thing, it pitches up. Well, it pitched up on them. They both jumped out fine, but we lost an airplane. Another one was the hook to the nav set, and so he was getting what he thought was right information, thinking he's right up, but he's actually in turn going down this way, jumped out. We had another one at the runway at Beale. The Concorde reminded me, he's on takeoff roll, zipping down the runway, and at that time it was either the tire or the wheel broke, poked a hole in the bottom of the aircraft. Now he's got fuel coming out there. Well, he's got the afterburners going, and so it's igniting the fuel. The procedure is return the throttles to idle, deploy the brake chute. Well, it's a nylon brake chute, 31 foot, and it's in the fire. Next thing, it's a ball of nylon on the runway. Well, Abe's heading off the end of the runway. Well, Beale had one of these cables that popped up, but the cable hadn't been tested in a while and popped up a little too high on one side, and it cut the cable, pulled the aircraft off this way, and the gear started to collapse on the airplane. Well, the backseater said, oh, I don't know if I can walk away from a burning airplane, so Jim goes bump and he ejects. Well, now the airplane stops. Abe, the pilot, opens the canopy, goes around to help Jim, and he's looking, where'd he go? Now he's coming down in a parachute over here. The factory lost one. Bill Weaver was his name, and it's on the internet. It's a very interesting story how he was out doing aft center of gravity tests. He's over New Mexico and goes into a turn, and the supersonic shockwave jumped out, but he's so far aft on the center, he said he had the stick full forward and it's still going up. The airplane broke apart at that particular part, threw he and the backseater out. Both of them came down fine. Their bodies came down fine. Bill was okay, but his backseater was a short-statured person and broke his neck in the pitch-up at that particular time. And part of his funny story is he's on the ground and he hears a voice out in the middle of the desert area of New Mexico. Are you okay? You okay? Bill said, yeah. You know, he looks around. Here's a farmer in a helicopter. And the farmer said, I heard the boom, looked up in the sky and saw the fuel coming out like this. Now they were at 80,000 feet in Mach 3 and a couple parachutes coming out. And so Bill said, go over and check on my backseater. And he said, yeah, he's about a half a mile away. So he flies over, finds out that the poor man had broken his neck. And now the farmer says, oh, got to get you to the hospital. So Bill's sitting in this guy's helicopter, and the guy's got it redlined. Man, that helicopter is going, shh, he's getting into the hospital as quick as he can. And Bill said, I just survived a Mach 3 accident, and I'm going to be killed in a helicopter. The factory lost another one in brake testing. It slipped off the runway, and the factory lost one. So there are many. The last one, odds finally caught up with them. You know, you got two engines, two generators, two hydraulic pumps. They're completely independent. So he's on a mission flying along the periphery of China, and at Mach 3, loses an engine. So he's controlling the airplane. They're getting set up to go into Taiwan. So now he's looking at lights on the one side for the engine. The generator's gone. The hydraulic pump is gone. No thrust out of that engine. All of a sudden, he's down and starts, you know, thinking, man, airplane's kind of handling sloppily. Now, all of a sudden, he sees a hydraulic quantity light on the good system. So when the engine blew, it poked a hole in the good line, and finally, at about 15,000 feet, he's lost complete control of the airplane. They punch out. A couple of Filipino farmers fishermen pick him up, take him to the Philippines. But that's one I call was, no pilot error, no nothing, just the odds caught up with you at that point.